All right, so welcome back to my channel. Today's video is gonna be a little bit different. Basically what happened was I was feeling really sad and I felt really just like I just hated my body because of everything going wrong with my body recently. And so I ended up just buying a ton of products from Truly Beauty to try to make myself feel better. And I'm gonna review them for you so that you know which ones to buy and which ones not to buy when you're shopping for fun or shopping for like retail therapy like I did or whatever. So we're gonna get started. I guess I can start with the two products that I absolutely hated. We have this mask called the Mary Jane CBD Glow Mask. And basically it's kind of a weird face mask because I'll show you what it looks like. It's basically like jelly. It's just like complete jelly. And basically what you do is you put it all over your face and it soaks in. So it's not like a face mask where you wash it off, it just like soaks into your face. So it's kind of weird. The reason as to why I hated it is because it reacted with my skin. So I put it on my face, it burned, it stung, it made my face feel tight and uncomfortable. So if you have sensitive skin like I do, don't buy this. Do not ever buy this. So that's how I feel about that one. This is the other product that is similar. It's the Mary Jane CBD Glow Serum. Basically, it's like, it's kind of got this like aloe vera type. It's got a lot of aloe in it. And I also hated it for the same reason, which is it made my face burn. Like this one, the second ingredient is phenoxyethanol. And I've looked into that ingredient and it can cause skin irritation in a lot of people. So don't like these. If you have sensitive skin, don't buy these. I did not actually mean to buy this. It's like it's a body butter. I didn't mean to buy this. It honestly wasn't in any of the kits that I bought either. I think that they accidentally shipped it to them because basically that's my receipt. It wasn't on any of my receipts, but it's the Acai Your Boobies body butter. And there were things I liked about it. It smells okay. You get a lot of product. It's just filled to the brim with product and it's a really, really thick body butter. So I've used it a number of times. I didn't like the texture. It was just so thick. And it turns your boobs purple when you use it. So that's the main problem I had with it, is that it turned my boobs purple and it was kind of greasy. So this is the Dulce de Leches Firming Boob and Belly Polish. I've used this a few times. It's hard to open. You can see that I've used it a few times. Like it's kind of depleted. And basically the idea of it is you put it on your like boobs and your belly in the shower and like it exfoliates them and moisturizes them. But I didn't feel like, when I was using it, I couldn't feel any like exfoliating beads or anything in it that was actually exfoliating my body. It was very soapy, which was sort of weird. And I noticed on the ingredients that it has sodium lauryl sulfate in it. So it's so soapy texture because it has a sulfate in it. They also market it as like being able to be used as a body mask. So like the idea is you can put it on your body before the shower and it like soaks in and treats stuff. That is not true, at least in my experience, because if I put it on before the shower, it basically melted all over my skin and it just felt gross. And then when I got in the shower, it would soap up, but there was no like body mask texture to it. The main plus of it is it does smell really good. It just smells like caramel. So if you like the caramel smell, that's a positive of this. So I mean, I wouldn't buy it again, but given that I have it, I will use it up, but I wouldn't buy it again. So then this is one that I do like. It's the Coco Cloud Aftershave Moisturizer. And something that I like about all of Truly's body butters is you do get a lot for what you pay for. This is just like a huge thing of body butter and it's so thick. Like it's just so, so thick and you get a lot. Like this, there's so much in it that it goes a long way. It's very moisturizing. It feels good after you've shaved. It soothes the skin. It does what it says it's gonna do. So if you want an aftershave body butter, put on your legs or armpits or whatever, I would recommend this. Let's see what else we have here. So these two products go together. It's the Berry Cheeky Clearing Butt Butter and then the Berry Cheeky Clearing Butt Polish. And I actually got the serum that goes with it too. The Berry Cheeky Serum. It's because like they truly markets their sets a lot. And so I wanted to at least get one full set. and the butt products appealed the most to me, so that's what I got. So I'll start with the polish. I was pretty dissatisfied with the packaging on the polish, because if you take a look, it's a lot of empty space because they didn't fill it all the way. So when they were like doing their swirl or whatever, I just didn't fill it all the way. This is like honestly like a lot of empty space. Like I didn't get my money's worth with it, but like it's filled at the top. It's just the sides are not really very filled. It does exfoliate, so that's a positive. It definitely exfoliates. It also was really soapy, like the Boob polish. It has sodium lauryl sulfate in it, so that's why it like gets so soapy in the shower. And it smells good, but again, I don't really see what it does that like a typical body scrub wouldn't do, and I don't love that it's soapy because I don't really see the purpose in that. So I wouldn't buy this again. I haven't even really used it much. I used it like once to see how it felt, and I haven't used it since. I just didn't see the purpose in it. Now this, I do like this. This is the Berry Cheeky Clearing Butt Butter. Like the whole way they've marketed these ones is like they're gonna help clear your skin, and they have like strawberry and blueberry and stuff in them. This is very thick, like the rest of the butters that I got. So I've used it a number of times and I've barely depleted it. So that's a good thing. It's very moisturizing. I haven't noticed that it's cleared my skin at all, but I mean, I like it. Not sure I'd buy it again just because I don't know if I need a butt butter. Like I can use any other body butter on my butt. I'm sure it works pretty much the same, but yeah, I mean, this was nice. I don't regret buying this. The serum. Something that I've noticed about a lot of their serums is they do contain aloe, which it is a good skin ingredient, but it's also like a very cheap ingredient, and they seem to have like the texture of aloe vera. So it's just like these are pretty pricey, and for like them to have so much really like cheap ingredient in them kind of questions why they cost that much, but whatever. Yeah, it's blue. Now this serum smells a lot better than the butter or the polish. Like I don't know what they did differently in scenting the serum, but this smells a lot better. I don't know why, but it just does. So this smells better. I've used it on my butt, like after my shower, after the shower. It's not clearing anything, but it smells good and it feels good to put it on. So I do like that. I'm not sure I'd buy it again. And then I, to keep in like the butt theme, I got the Titan and Glow Serum, which is watermelon. It smells very, very watermelon-y, which is the main plus of it, I would say, because I haven't noticed any effects from it. But it's moisturizing and it smells like watermelon, so I like that. Wouldn't buy this again, but it's lasting a long time, like it's barely depleted, and I've used it a lot, so I'll see how I feel, but I mean, it's all right. We have the hair masks. Well, some I bought a lot of hair masks from them. We have some of the hair masks. I used the Hydrate and Shine, and I liked it. Like, I liked it. It made my hair feel nice and soft and shiny for a few days. It doesn't last. The effects don't last, so like, once it's been a few days, that's basically it, but I did like it. I would probably buy it again. Now this is supposed to be moisturizing for like the roots. It's the Rainbows and Mirrors Split End Treatment. I admittedly, this is the only product that I have not tried. I meant to try it. I just haven't had time to do like, because these have to sit for like 10 minutes, like an hour, and I haven't had time to like do an hour long face mask. So I haven't tried this, but I assume it's probably gonna be good. So I'm not opposed to these. Okay, this is actually, I didn't try this product either. It's only these two products I didn't try. And the reason being, you have to just have a lot of time on your hands to put this in your hair and have this in your hair for like a long time, and I just haven't had that time. But this is the Coco Rose Fudge. I did smell this one. It doesn't smell very good. So that's part of why I haven't wanted to use it, because it doesn't smell good. And it's supposed to smell like rose and it just doesn't. So I don't like how it smells. I don't know. Maybe I will never use it. I don't know about that. Now these are like in the category of products that I love. These, excuse me, by the way, these are the same, but the cocoa oil. Basically, I have very, 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 very sensitive skin, especially when I shave. Like I cannot shave my legs or my armpits or anything else more often than once a week, or I will get like a rash, I'll bleed, it'll be really, really bad. So I can't shave as often as maybe some other people can shave. So I'm very, very prone to ingrowns. I'm very, very prone to just irritation. It's a struggle for me. So these are freaking amazing. I would buy these again. I will probably never not have these with me. Like, I love these. Truly did a truly amazing job with these ones. The cocoa concentrate, it is pretty pricey and you don't get that much, but you also don't need that much. And I've noticed that if I have any ingrown hair anywhere, I put it on, the redness like immediately goes away. And then I'll usually use this cocoa oil whenever I shave, on my legs, armpits, wherever. So I love, love, love these. Would buy these again, will always use these. So that was like, I don't know where to put it, in a different section of like the products I loved, but they'll go over here. Now this is another body butter. I got it because I wanted to try the scent. It's the Coco Rose Fudge. The scent on this is unreal. It's just unreal. It literally smells like a bouquet of roses. It feels so good on your skin, an amazing body butter. I would buy this again. I also gave some to my mom and she is in love with it. Like, they have like a jumbo version. You can buy like a really, really big one of it. And I gave that to my mom and she loved it. So this is going in the product I love category. These are two of the same because I got some of Truly's sets, and they also have this thing on their website where, like, if you buy a certain amount on a certain day, you get like a gift, and like, you don't need to choose it. You just get it and it is free. So that's how I ended up with two of these body butters. One I don't think has been used, so I think one of them, you can see the swirl on it still. Yeah, well, I used a tiny bit of it, oops. But they do have the swirl on their products, like they advertise. It smells good. Yeah, I don't know how to describe how it smells. It just smells like pleasantly fruity. This is basically a fruity version, and it is rainbow, like they advertise. It's definitely rainbow. It's kind of a fruity version of the Coco Rose body butter. I think their body butters are an area where they really do excel because they're so thick and you get so much for your money, like, because they go so far. So I like this body butter. I don't know if I would buy it again because I like some of the other scents more, but yeah, it's great. The biggest problem with their body butters though is I think they designed them to be put on after you've put like one of their serums or body oils on. So it's really hard to spread the body butter if you don't have something else on. So normally I'll use one of their lotions or other type of oil before I put a body butter on, or it just won't spread. So that's the main flaw, but I don't even know if it's a flaw because like the thickness of the body butter is so nice, and I don't think I would like it if they were thin and easy to spread, because then they wouldn't be a body butter. So complicated feelings, but I like these. I'll put them in the light category, I guess. Well, I guess I can move the hair masks over too. I don't know. Yeah, I'll put them. Like, I don't know. I don't love these though. Like, I don't love these hair masks. Like, I don't know if I'd buy them again because, like, the effects don't last. Like, they only last for, like, when you use it. So, I don't know. They'll stay over here, I guess. Now, these body scrubs, I also kind of hate these. I mean, they're perfectly fine body scrubs. You can see, like, they have nice color. They're nice and thick. You know, this is a smooth legend pre-shave scrub, and this is the Moon Rocks Whipped Body Scrub. And the reason I kind of hate these is really because of the price. So I believe the Smooth Legend one is $25. I think that the Moon Rocks is $20. So they're really expensive, and you only get like a 4 ounce thing of a body scrub, and they have a lot of ingredients in them. I've looked into the ingredients in them. They have a lot of ingredients, some great, some more like but I just don't feel like they do that much. Like, they scrub, but they don't leave your skin feeling like super soft and moisturized like I would want from a high-end scrub. So actually, these inspired me to make my own body scrubs. I've been doing some of my friends and they really liked it. And I put all these great skin oils in it, essential oils. They have more aromatherapy, they have more moisturization than either of these scrubs that were really, really expensive. So I would never buy these again. I would just rather make my own. And so that is that. This kind of leads me a little bit into the video series that I'm planning on doing, where I recreate versions of popular beauty products, including Truly products. And also I want to do some from Lush as well. And I'll be recreating these body scrubs first. So stay tuned for those videos. And then I also made this, which I love. So that was great. This product, the Coco Cloud Whipped Shave Butter, you can see I've used a lot of it. And I actually bought two of these, so I have another one that I've used some of as well. I have mixed feelings about this product because I do like it and I do shave with it, but there are some definite flaws that I grapple with. So the main thing is, and I saw this commented a lot, if you get it wet, it dissolves. So like if you're putting it on a wet leg or a wet armpit or something, it just dissolves and you have to use so much of it, which is really frustrating because like this tiny thing was $20. So I don't want to like waste it and use a ton of it, you know? For me, it's a little less of a problem because I shave, like I said, like once a week, or I have a lot of problems. So I only shave once a week, but it's still expensive, you know, to use a ton of a $20 product. So like whenever I use it now in the shower, I have to like bring like a washcloth and like hang it up on the shower and like then pull it down and like at my legs dry before I put it on. So that is a flaw. I wish it worked better if your legs are wet, because I feel like most of us shave in the shower. It's annoying if it's dry. I don't know if I'd buy it again, but it works better than most shaving creams that I've used. So I don't know, I'm conflicted about it, but I do use it every time I shave now, so I guess it goes in the liked category. So I will say that I bought like this one set called the Pineapple Haze set, and this set is my favorite thing that I've bought set-wise from Truly, because all of these products worked really, really well. So this is a extreme repair hand and foot cream. It's like yellow, has a scent of pineapple, just like a beautiful, beautiful scent of pineapple. It smells just so fruity and it really helps my hands. I have really, really bad skin on my hands because I overwash them technically. So this does wonders for me. I would buy this again. Like, I don't want to be without this. I like this a lot. This is amazing hand cream. Soaks in quickly. Super moisturizing. I love this. Skin Salve that I got with it. It's all right. You don't get a lot of it. So like you get a tiny bit of it. I think it's meant for like super dry areas of your skin or whatever. It's all right. I've used it before I go to bed because I can't use it during the day or my hands will be too greasy. If I use it before I go to bed, it seems to be all right. This I like a lot. The Pineapple Haze Sensitive Skin Body Balm. Like you get a lot of product with it. It smells just like pineapples. And they put wax in it as like the emulsifier. So it's a little waxy, but that's okay. It has a few chunks in it. So if you're supposed to be like a perfectly thin lotion, then you're not gonna get that. It's more of like a incredible version of this, really. Very moisturizing. It smells really good. I use it on my whole body and I like this. I would buy this again. I like this a lot. I would buy all these pineapple products again. Then it also comes with a lip butter, which still kind of has a swirl in it a little bit. And then you get a lip polish as well, which is a little thicker. I think it has some sugar or something in it to polish your lips. And I like both of these a lot. I've used them a few times and they're not really very depleted. So I feel like they're gonna last me a long, long time. They're just so smoothing. My lips feel so good after using them. They smell like fresh pineapple. So how can you be sad about that? They're really, really awesome. The polish gets my lips like so smooth. And then the butter is so buttery. I love it. And then I also have, in terms of lip products, the Unicorn Fruit Plumping Balm, and you can still see the swirl on it because I haven't used that much of it. But I love this because it smells so minty. Okay, so as I was saying, it looks great, it feels great, it's tingly, it's minty, it's moisturizing. I like this a lot. So we're really down to the last three products. I will say about these last three products, I like them a lot overall. I'll start with the body lotion. So this body lotion, it's the perfecting creams, goes to target like cellulite and stretch marks. I have not really used it for that. I've more so used it for like targeting dry skin, and it definitely does that. It has really simple ingredients. This I think is one of their cleanest products. Very simple ingredients. I would definitely buy this again. I use it as a full body moisturizer. It's kind of got this purple color, super smooth and soft. I typically use this like all over my body before I use one of their body butters, because then the body butter is like sinking better because my skin is like moisturized already. So I like these. This would buy this again. Now this is another product that I love. Love, love, love this product. This product is probably on the level of these. Like I love it as much as these. I never want to be without it again. Love this product. I haven't looked too deep into the ingredients on this one, so I can't speak for how clean it is, but it is amazing. So it's supposed to be a hair mask, and it does not work as a hair mask. Like I used it as a hair mask once, and basically my hair did not feel any better. However, it is perfect perfect, perfect for using as a leave-in conditioner. And it works better than any leave-in conditioner that I've ever, ever, ever used. Or it's leaking now. The problem with like these is like they pressurize the product so it comes out if you just like uncap it. That's the main problem with that packaging. But like it smells exactly like the toothpaste you used to get as a kid that smelled like cotton candy or bubblegum. It smells exactly like bubblegum, and it makes my hair just feel softer and nicer than any other leave-in conditioner I've ever used. No frizz. Like my hair usually is really dry and I have it in now, and I love this. Love this, love this, love this. If you have dry hair like I do and you need a leave-in conditioner, I would recommend buying this. I just would. It's worth the money, it's perfect. And then this is the last product that we have. It is their glazed donut aftershave oil. It's purple, so like when you get it in the thing, it's purple. And it feels really good after you shave. It just feels really good, and I like using it because it makes putting a body butter on a lot easier. And it also seems to last a while because I've used this after every time that I've shaved for a while, and I've used it generously, and it's barely depleted. So another positive thing, it doesn't smell like a glazed donut. I don't really know what it smells like, but I like it a lot. I would buy it again. I would 100% buy it again. So I guess like this pile here is kind of the products that I would buy again. And then the pile kind of I put off to the side over here is like the products that I wouldn't buy again at all. But I'll use them as long as they last, besides the two for the face that made my face burn. I wouldn't use those for obvious reasons. The rest of them, I'll use them until they like use up. But then these I will probably buy again. So if you got to this far, I hope this was helpful. I hope you know what products you would or would not buy from Truly. If you have other recommendations for Truly products or other criticisms, leave them in the comments. And then I do want to say that this video is gonna hopefully be the start of a larger skincare series that I wanna do. I'm actually really passionate about skincare. I haven't expressed it much on this channel because there's been a lot of other stuff going on in my life, but I would like to get a lot more into skincare videos, and I want to do a lot of recipes and tutorials on how to recreate a lot of popular beauty products, including Truly products, but also Lush products, or even just recipes that I make up out of my head. So there will be a lot of skincare content incoming. For the time being, I hope this is helpful for deciding what Truly products you would like to use in your life or buy or whatever. Hope this is helpful to all y'all. So this is hopefully helpful, and I hope y'all have a really good rest of your day.